This is another edition of So You Think You Can Squat. Now that we have the head fixed and we know that the head has to stay up to squat, the next thing we're gonna work on is the chest and abs. Now, when you're squatting, the chest has to stay upright. Too many times when guys are lifting, when they pick the rack up, what's gonna happen is their chest is gonna do this. It's gonna fall over and it's already gonna cause you to be in this position, which is not a good position to squat any kind of weight. So you wanna keep that chest up. And that follows by keeping the head up. This locked in good position is key to squatting big weights. The next thing is right here. This part right here cannot move once the bar is picked up. From here up, it should look like that bar, nothing's changing. That thing should stay locked like a piece of granite the whole time, okay? One of the other most important things from what I would consider the core down is tailbone. Now what you're gonna want to see is this does not, it should not be flat. You should try to tilt this out and then pinch this up. This is what you want to see, a nice slope on his tailbone. This puts his body in an optimal position to lift crazy amounts of weight. If you can't hold this position right here, you can't squat. I don't care how strong your legs are, because you will fall over. So you want to make sure that this area is very, very strong and also keeps a nice slope the entire time that you're squatting. Now we got to work our way down. The next thing that we have to work on is all this here. The knees have to draw out the whole time. A squat is not an up and down exercise. It's a pushing out exercise. By pushing out, you learn to squat with the glute, the upper quad, and utilize all of this in one integral unit versus in pieces. If your knees shoot forward, the only thing you can stand up with is your quad. If you sit back, you can utilize the glute, the quad, the lower back, and the entire core to make the weights work, okay? This is one of the most important factors of making sure that you can squat big, big weights. Okay, so now we are good. We're good from here up. We realize that we have to push the knee out to engage the hip. We realize that this has to be in a nice curve. We realize that the head and the upper body has to stay locked. The last thing that goes through your head when you're squatting big weights is foot pressure. Now, when you're squatting, the foot pressure needs to be on the outside of the shoe and the majority in the middle to the back part of the heel. That's where all the pressure needs to stay on your foot. If pressure shifts to the toe, then I guarantee if you look at the top, the knees have come forward, the quads end up doing most of the work. So it's very, very important to maintain that lateral pressure all the way from picking up the bar to squatting to even racking it. As long as the hip takes most of the pressure, everything works in the integral unit. So this is dominant, everything works. If something else takes it, it's isolated. And an isolated squat equals high injury and bad form. The next big key is most of you guys will not have the ability to have a monolift to squat. So it's gonna be impossible or pretty much a waste of time for me to teach you how this thing works, because if you don't have access to it, it doesn't matter. So I'm gonna teach you how, if this was a normal power rack, which most colleges and all these people have, how do you actually do those correctly? The key with walking out, since we have everything fixed, is you pick, when you pick this bar up out of the rack, you pick it up like you're gonna take it for a squat. Everything's locked, all the pressure that we talked about straight, standing up. Then you start with your walkout. You don't start stagger stance, okay? So I don't have a foot in front of the other, because if you got 800-900 pounds, you just straight legged one leg, 800 pounds, how's that gonna work? So usually you'll see that with lighter weights, but you will never see it with heavy weights. You pick up everything with both legs, okay? So we'll have him crawl under the bar. He's gonna go over all the checkpoints in his head. So the first thing he does is he sets the bar on his back, picks his head up, locks his upper back. Then he's gonna lock his abs and his tailbone. He's gonna push his knees out. And he's gonna put lateral pressure on his feet. So he's gonna do a partial squat, go ahead. Now he's gonna take a small 2-inch step back with whichever foot he likes. Then he'll do it again. Okay, now he's set up where he likes to be, which is a moderate stance squat, pretty common for most athletes. Not too wide, not too narrow. He's got plenty of distance between the pin and the bar, but not too much where he has to walk it back another 10 feet. Now the first motion of the squat is to sit back first and push the knees out. Good. Stand it back. Now the key with this is teaching you, no matter what you do, your head stays high. Your head stays up. You don't look at your feet. You don't look at anything that's going on. This is when this exercise turns into proprioception. You have to understand what your body's doing without looking. That's why you stay away from mirrors and you stay with guys that know good form. Again, just a partial squat. This is the proper form and the proper loading pattern of the start of the squat. Now, when he goes to rack this in, he's going to take small steps and keep his head high. Now, good.